I spent the last couple weeks trying to figure out how to say or to talk on stage, and had the script and everything, but I threw it out because Tina told me that when I'm going by script, I'm all over the place. No one's supposed to keep me on track. So I just, because of all the other women sharing their stories, I just decided I'm just gonna explain how my transformation came. 3 years ago, I was sleeping in the back seat of my car and was homeless after an 18-year marriage. And that's kind of where the decision came that I was gonna stop giving to everybody else. And it was time for me to take care of me. I lost two different companies that I had started behind making bad choices in relationships and self-esteem issues, things like that that put you in positions where you accept things that you're not supposed to. And I did it for 18 years. But the best day was when that was over and I was sleeping in that back seat of the car. It was really cold out. It was raining. I could hear it on the sunroof. And my brother, my little brother there, and my daughters, I couldn't tell them that I was literally living in the back seat of my car because I had always had money and companies. And I just didn't want anybody to know that I was, that it had gotten that bad. But like I said, it was the best thing that ever happened to me 3 years ago. I lost everything. I had nothing. I gave most of it up, but I lost everything. And literally was sleeping on my brother's couch and my daughter's couch talking about, oh, I'm just, you know, where me and him are fighting. I'm just over here for the night, but was literally living out of my car. During that time, I had, even though I had let the business go, I still had the contracts. So I was able to like get my sales from the backseat of my car, just doing online stuff. But it was minimal, obviously wasn't a call center and 32 employees. I hustled with DoorDash. I used DoorDash to kind of get a place to stay. It took me about a week and a half and working 24/7 with DoorDash. I was renting a car, $300 a week. The select suites was $400 a week, so $700 a week before I could even eat. DoorDash did that for me. I'm grateful to DoorDash because during that week period of time of being in the backseat of my car, I had made a decision that if I build companies before, I can build them again. And this time I was gonna do it on my own and I wasn't gonna involve anybody in my situation ever again. I was gonna have $1 million companies snatched away from me from anybody else ever again. So I knew how to do it. I've done it before. I just was new to how to do it online. But I was learning quickly because I was desperate and I was in the back seat of my car. So $700 a week was really hard to make consistently with DoorDash. So I needed immediate something to happen with the business, and that's how come I quickly learned how to get leads off of the internet and off of Facebook and turn that into the business that I have today. What I want to say is in the backseat of that car, that 1 week that I was sleeping in it, God is the only thing that got me through. Yeah. I was raised as a Jehovah's Witness, so I have deep understanding of how God can help you through tough times. You just got to go to him, and I spent many years not going to him and depending on a man or going to him or being manipulated to think that marriage is about submission and to idiots, something like that. You know, the people with no direction, and then they're guiding you to no direction. Once that hit me, it changed everything because I was able to realize, though he would always say, like one of the other ladies had mentioned, that like you're no good, or you wouldn't be here without me, and if it wasn't for me, you wouldn't even have this. When I'm doing all the work, and when it hit me in the car that I lost two companies behind men that were telling me that I wasn't nothing, but I built the company from nothing, from kitchen tables and nothing, and I built companies. And that realization is what gave me Then I just prayed, because like I was alone. I didn't want my brother, I didn't want my parents, I didn't want my kids to know that I had went to nothing. And I was determined to not let that be the end of it.
Yeah.
Because I knew I was better than that. I knew I was better than accepting what I accepted for 18 years. And the reason I say that backseat was the best day of my life, because that's, you can't do nothing but go up from there. What can you do? I didn't have the luxury to waddle in my misery, because I'm not going to stay here. That's not going to happen. And I had a lot of catching up to do, because I had lost companies. And I had a lot of learning to do, because digital marketing was all new to me. So I say that during that time, I committed to leaving men alone just completely. And I did that for, and I tell my brother that all the time, I was like, my one tip for success when you've gone through a trauma like that, an ending to something that was long, whether it was good or bad, is I just made a decision that I don't have any choice but to move forward. And that now, being at the bottom, since you can only go up, then just do whatever it takes to go up. And if it gets hard, I didn't have the luxury to say, oh, this is tough, oh, it's cold in the backseat, or I have to work DoorDash 24/7 and almost kill myself driving because I'm so tired. But I was determined to get back. That built the stamina and the determination in me. If I can do that daily with DoorDash for a week and get a place, I can move and do something better, quicker. I learned digital marketing. I stopped doubting myself. I stopped thinking that it was somebody else that was making me successful when it was all within me. And then God gave me the strength of having at least a few people that I was able to at least sleep on their couch, like my brother and my daughter, and gave me the strength to know that I have daughters. I have two daughters, and I didn't want them to see me be not successful after a hardship, because they're married and one of them's in a semi-okay marriage, I don't know. And because you know, when we're in abusive relationships, most people around us don't know, but you kind of, you know, the parents, you know, I look at my guy like, I don't know. But, and it's not obvious, but the other one has a good marriage. And what I didn't want to do is be the example of, I let this man beat me down to nothing, and then I just stayed in it. So my motivation came from my kids and my brother, because he was struggling, and I wanted him to see that you can start from nothing and still be 50, and your whole world seemed like it got snatched away, and not think about what happened in the past, because it does you no good to think about that. It drains you. You're already in it. You're in the shit. You're in it. So like, there's no need to like stay in it with your mind. So the only way to move forward is think forward. And that's all I had the luxury to do, because it was tough during that time. But I can stand here today and say thank you, God, because I made it through. I made it through. And 100 times better is a minimal compared to what I was making back then for somebody who didn't even care about me. So I just want you all to know, I want to thank Tina, because previous to meeting Tina and the Bridge Builders, I'm a total introvert, so I can make money sitting at home behind a computer. I like that. It's cool to me. I think it's great to be able to have the ability to turn ideas into income just from a computer. So I'm an introvert. I've never like interacted. I don't have girlfriends. I don't have any friends. And when I seen Tina, I had watched her for a year on Facebook, and I was like, I want to be a part of that. And then just one day, I just was like, oh, I'm just going to hit her and just ask her, how do I be, my exact typing in the Facebook was, how can I be a part of that? That's all I said to her, and she hit me back, and from that process on, my life has been totally transformed. Yes, God, yes, I have supported people, but if it wasn't for the Bridge Builders, I would have never come out of the house. I just sit in the house and make money. And this has been such an enlightening, and gives me so much more view of the world than 18 years staying in a house and now keeping that bondage on myself. I wanted to come out of it, and I picked the right organization to do that.
All right.
She was homeless in her car, but she chose not to stay there. She said she chose to think forward, and then look at her now. It is so amazing that we have options. That if we just sit there and we just think about it, if we get in that quiet space, because I always say that everything we need is inside of us, because it's really the God in us.
Yes, Lord.
So if we take the time to get quiet and get still, He'll give us the thoughts that we're supposed to have. And He'll teach us the lessons that we're supposed to learn along the way. So now we're going to keep on moving on. But I have to tell you guys this, because I just love when you have a chance to be real. Okay? When you can be authentic. Because I like to tell everybody I'm authentic. A lot of